Hello from Melbourne Airport, where today we'll be flying with Virgin Australia up to the Gold Coast. Check-in was fairly simple, as there were plenty of self-service machines around, and these are ones which are able to print boarding passes. Airside in T4, there's a big food hall, but as our plane will be departing from the original T3 gates, we have to walk over to that side. And here's our 13-year-old 737-800, which will shortly be taking us up to Queensland. Most of the gates here in the Virgin Terminal are fantastic because of the amazing views that they offer out over the aircraft, and our gate is no exception. So after a short wait near the gate, watching our plane being prepared for departure, it was soon time to board. Being seated in the back half of the plane meant that we got to board via the rear stairs, which is something I'm never going to complain about. My seat for this flight is 16A, just a few rows behind the emergency exits. We pushed back right on time, with it being a beautiful day here in Melbourne, and a very nice looking cabin inside too, with Virgin's signature purple mood lighting.
Just one runway in utilisation this morning for departures and arrivals, so there's a bit of a backlog in traffic, so we're waiting for our turn to take off. I think probably another 5 minutes before we get underway. Flight time up to Gold Coast, 1 hour and 50 minutes, that's actually pretty good. So at this stage we're not showing a late arrival into the Gold Coast, but we'll know more about that once we get underway. Good flying today, the weather up there is nice, currently it's 22 degrees, possibility of some showers later on this afternoon. Anyway, folks, once again, welcome aboard. Thanks for joining us. We'll be underway shortly.
Now that we're airborne, let's take a look around the seat, which you might recognise from last week's Rex video, as they had the exact same design. There's a standard adjustable tray table, as well as a large seat back pocket and small pouch in front of it. There's a headrest on the seat back as well, which is adjustable in all the usual ways. The seat does also recline, and the centre armrests are also adjustable. On the back of the leather seats, there's a coat hook, and air vents are above as well, which on this plane are of the more newer Boeing design. Now let's take a look at the onboard menu. The prices of things seem to be of similar, if not slightly higher, than that of Jetstar, although from what I saw of other people buying things, their qualities seem to be a little better. I ordered the banana bread, which is an item Jetstar also sells. It seemed to be very nice, although maybe a little bit smaller than their counterpart. Although one thing that I think Jetstar definitely wins in the banana bread contest is that theirs didn't stick to the outsides, which I found quite annoying in Virgin's packaging. I've looked at Virgin's onboard entertainment in previous videos, but here's a quick little recap of the Wi-Fi, entertainment and other things that they offer on board. The last thing to do before we land is to check out the toilet. This is one of the rear toilets on board, and its cleanliness was pretty good, and there never seemed to be too much of a queue. Soon enough, we were descending and making the very scenic approach into the Gold Coast. We again used the rear stairs to disembark, which is something that's almost guaranteed here at the Gold Coast. Overall, that was a fairly good flight with Virgin Australia. The seats are adequate for a 2-hour flight like this, and the entertainment they offer has a good selection and Wi-Fi at reasonable prices too. Their food and beverage selection is similar to that of their counterpart Jetstar, so overall they make for a perfectly fine ride up here to the beautiful Gold Coast.